Good morning, students. Today I am come here to teach you the next part of the chapter, seeds, that is germination. Now, what is this germination? Last time we studied about seeds, the structure of the bean seed and the maize seed. Today we shall be studying about germination. So, a seed, what does it contain? It contains a dormant embryo. What do you mean by dormant? It is in a state of sleep. Okay, it is not functional. So it is having a dormant embryo. It is in a state of dormancy. The chemical activities are going on and on. We can say the chemical activities are happening inside the seed. That is, it consumes oxygen and it is giving out carbon dioxide and even releasing heat as well. When given proper conditions, it awakens and starts growing into a new seedling, and this process is known as germination. Meaning that when we give it the seed now, which is in the dormant state, if you give it the adequate necessary conditions of temperature, water and oxygen, then the seed will start germinating. The process of formation of a seedling develops from an embryo. So, what is this germination? It is the process of formation of a seedling from the embryo. A fresh seed does not normally germinate. It must go through the state of dormancy. So, where rarely do we see a fresh seed which is germinating? It goes through that state of dormancy. The reason for that, the embryo has to develop. Okay, so it has to develop. So, it needs that state of dormancy. That is physiological maturation. It needs to mature physiologically so that it can be able to produce a new seedling. Now, what are the conditions for germination? Okay, you've studied in your lower classes, there are three important conditions, that is water, that is suitable temperature and oxygen. We will study in detail these three conditions. First condition is water. How is this water now absorbed into the seed? When you soak the seeds in water, you observe that they become little big. Okay, they increase in size. Why do they increase in size? Because now this seed absorbs water. Through which part of the seed does it absorb water? Through the micropyle, which we learned last time about the micropyle. It is close to the hilum. It is a little pore which is lying close to the hilum. Okay, that scar part of the seed. Okay, now the seed swells and the seed coat ruptures. Okay, when the seed swells, the coat of it ruptures, it breaks open, because naturally the plumule and the radical have to come out. So, allowing the radical to form the root system. The enzymes act on the food that is stored in the cotyledons to convert it into diffusible form to be used for the growing embryo. Now, what happens is there are enzymes which start their reaction. Once the water enters into the seed, now the enzymes start reacting. Okay, how do they react? They help to store, to prepare food. Okay, this food is stored in the cotyledons. Okay, so that it can be used. This food that is stored in cotyledons is there to supply the energy to the growing plant. Okay, there, because it has got no leaves, how will it prepare its food? So it is a cotyledon that is preparing the food for the growing seedling. Now, the next condition is suitable temperature. Low temperature inhibits the growth of the embryo. So, if you supply a good temperature, then if you supply a low temperature, then the seedling is unable to grow. Seed is unable to germinate. Low temperature inhibits means does not help or stops the growth of the embryo. While a higher temperature, what does it do? It will destroy the tissues. Okay, it will not help. So, both high and low temperature is not a good thing. You need a moderate temperature. The temperature is 25 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius. That's a favorable temperature, and that's also known as the optimum temperature. The seeds of tropical plants now need higher temperature than those of the temperate plants. Okay, seeds, we have observed that seeds of tropical plants require higher, much higher temperature than that of the temperate plants. This could be due to the presence of more moisture in the air. Now, the next condition for germination is oxygen. Now, during germination, there is rapid growth, okay, for which energy is required. The seed is tremendously activated. It is growing rapidly. Okay, so for this, energy is required. Now, how does it get its energy? This energy is available only by respiration. That is the oxidation of the food. The seeds fail to germinate if you are sowed deep into the ground. So sometimes you observe that if you have a potted plant, if you are trying to grow a seedling, okay, germinate a seedling in your pot, okay, if you dig deep into the ground and you put the seedling, sow the seed there, if you sow the seed deep down, it will be unable to germinate. What is the reason? The reason is deep down there is no supply of oxygen. Okay, oxygen will be much less deep down and insufficient pushing force in the embryonic parts. Now, this embryonic parts, okay, the growing embryo has to have enough energy to push, okay, to push through and come out, okay, to break through the upper layers of the soil. So, it requires more pushing force, which it is not able to achieve. Okay, so that is why this can come as a give reason question. Why do seeds fail to germinate if they are so deep into the soil? Okay, so the two reasons are there. First of all, insufficient supply of oxygen deep down, and then the insufficient pushing force of the embryonic parts. Okay, now there are few experiments you have to learn about the germination. Okay, the factors that is required for the germination. Number one factor is water. Water is necessary for germination. Okay, we are going to prove this by an experiment. First, you take two beakers, beaker A and beaker B. In beaker A, you take wet cotton wool and you place green gram moon. Okay, moon seeds on that. In beaker B, what do you take? You take a dry cotton wool. Put green gram, that is also the seeds, okay, moon seeds. Now, one is wet cotton wool, one is dry cotton wool. Keep it in ordinary room for about 1 to 2 days. What will you observe? You will observe that beaker A, which is having the wet cotton wool, it will germinate, okay, and not the seeds in beaker B. Okay, so what can you conclude from this? That water is essential for germination. Now we come to the next factor, that next experiment, that is to prove the suitable temperatures required for germination. Now here, what do we do? Beaker A, wet cotton wool, green gram seeds in ordinary room temperature. Beaker B, wet cotton wool, green gram seeds, and keep it in the refrigerator. Seeds A, what will happen? Obviously, they will germinate. They were in the proper temperature, room temperature. B seeds will not germinate because you have kept it in the refrigerator, or it might take longer time to germinate. You got it? It might take longer time to germinate. Conclusion, suitable temperature is necessary for the seeds to germinate. So, that was experiment 2. We move on to experiment 3. Now, oxygen is necessary for germination. For that, you take two conical flasks. You can see the diagram there. It is of the conical flask. Conical flask A, conical flask B. In this also, again, you have to take soaked green gram seeds and wet cotton wool and lower a test tube containing pyrogallic acid. So, understand this, in test tube A and in test tube B, the common things are soaked gram seeds, wet cotton wool. Both we are giving wet cotton wool, both we are giving soaked gram seeds. Now, what is the difference? Difference is in flask A, we have put the pyrogallic acid. Okay, we are taking a test tube containing pyrogallic acid and trying to lower it. You are lowering it into the conical flask. And in the B flask, what are we taking? We are taking a test tube which is containing ordinary water. Now, what is important of this pyrogallic acid is that it is able to absorb oxygen. It has got a property. Pyrogallic acid has got a property that it absorbs oxygen. Wherever you keep pyrogallic acid, the oxygen in the surroundings get absorbed. So, what do you think will happen to flask A? All the oxygen that is present in that flask A will be absorbed by pyrogallic acid. So, there will be no oxygen. And what will happen to flask B? You have kept ordinary water. Okay, so the oxygen will be as it is. So, obviously, you can understand what will be our conclusion, or rather, observe in the two flasks. We can observe that flask A, the seeds will germinate. Sorry, the three seeds will not germinate, and flask B, the seeds will germinate. Why didn't it germinate in flask A? The reason for it is because of the absence of oxygen. So, we come to the conclusion that oxygen is necessary for germination. So, that was your third experiment. Now we go on to the 3-bean seed experiment. So like the name suggests, you need 3 bean seeds, 2-3 mature brain seeds. Take them and you need a glass slide. Okay, you take a glass slide. I think I showed you all last time in the laboratory. So you take that glass slide, you put the bean seeds at equal distances, you tie them to the glass slide. And then you have to insert it into a beaker containing water, the way it is shown in the diagram there. Okay, in such a way that one of the seeds is out of the beaker, the top seed is outside. Okay, it is rather not touching the water at all. The middle seed, it is half in the water, half outside, while as the third seed is totally submerged in the water. And now what do? We keep this experimental setup in a warm place for a few days. Okay, and after a few days, you will come back and check your experiment. What do we observe? Now the top seed, what will happen? Is there germination? No. No germination, because though it is getting oxygen, it has not got the water. Okay. Now what happens to the middle seed? It germinates because it gets both oxygen as well as water. Bottom seed, it has got enough water, it is totally submerged in water, but is it getting oxygen? Little bit. Okay, so you can see that little bit, but not so much. Okay, does not germinate or stops germinating after the emergence of a small radical. It just starts germinating little bit, a little bit of radical starts coming out and then it stops growing. So what can we conclude? That water is required for germination. However, that oxygen is not fully demonstrated, because here in that, what is happening is that third seed, which is in water, it is slightly showing little bit of the growth of the radical. But however, this experiment concludes, we can conclude that water is absolutely necessary for the seeds to germinate. So that's the 3-bean seed experiment. That's all for today. Thank you so much, children. Goodbye.